Question number 2 deals with what? Yes? Superposition principle. It is nothing but vector law. That is, if there are two forces acting on an object, what is the resultant force? If you know this, you can answer it. It is equivalent to your resultant of 2, 3, 4 vectors. So, we will cover up one concept example first before we proceed for derivation. Superposition principle concept example. Notes bandh kar do. There are three objects A, B, C. Three objects A, another object B, same mass. Third object C, all mass is M. Distance between the two is L, say 1 meter. Mass is say 2 kg. Find force, resultant force on A due to B and See, this is what we want to find out. Draw the diagram. One full page. Anyone who can help this procedure. Force on A due to C. Here along this direction, force on A due to B, some magnitude, say F naught, only magnitude. Along this line, force on A due to C, its magnitude is also F naught. Why same magnitude? Capital G. Force on A due to B magnitude, force on A due to C magnitude, let it be F naught is equal to capital G M1 M2 by R square. R is here, L square. Magnitude is same. If there are two vectors inclined at certain angle, what this angle is equal to? Yeah, 60 degree equilateral triangle, all sides are same length, angle between the two is 60 degree. So there is one vector, another vector, angle between the two is 60 degree. How you find the resultant? Yes, the resultant of the two is along this line FR, which you have to find out. Resultant formula is, yes, A square plus B square plus C square, sorry, A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta, first force square, second force square plus 2, first force into second force into cos of angle theta. It is equal to what? F naught. This is also equal to F naught. 2 F naught into F naught cos theta. Theta here is what? 60. Cos theta is equal to cos 60 is equal to what? 1 by 2. So it is 1 by 2 and root. 2, 2 cancel. 1 F naught square. 1 F naught square. And this also F naught square. How many times? 3 times. So it is root 3 F naught is equal to root 3. F naught is equal to what? capital G M M by L square is equal to what? Root 3 G 6.67 into 10 raised to power minus 11 into mass. Yes, each object, each mass is 2 kg. So 2 into 2 divided by L square. L is equal to what? 1 square. Solve and answer. 2 minutes. That means only the name is different, superposition, but actually it is nothing but resultant of 2, 3, 4, any number of vectors. Answer please, any one of the answer. Yes, 2.64 into 10 raised to power, yes, minus 10, yes. How many of you are getting this answer? 2.64 into 10 raised to power minus 10. So, units, yes. Into root 3, exact answer please. Exact answer is 4.5 into 10 to the power minus 10, fine. Now we take up the derivation part of the same. This was concept example. That means if you know it, that means you know superposition principle. It is nothing but simple vector addition. Now, there is an object M naught. It is acted upon by number of objects, mass M1. M naught, there is a force on this object. F naught 1, we will find out this value due to mass M1 and place another mass M2, there will be force on M naught, yes, due to 2 F naught 2. There are n such masses Mn. Then force F naught n is also there. All these are vectors. Superposition principle is resultant gravitational force F acting on a particle due to number of point masses is equal to the vector sum, not simple algebraic sum, which sum? Vector sum of all the forces exerted by individual masses on the given particle. That means what? F is equal to what? Resultant force is equal to what? F naught 1, F naught 2. You take into account all such masses, then it is F naught n. This distance between the two, your choice. You can write R naught 1 or R 1 naught. You will follow the same convention followed here. It is R 1 naught, R 1 naught. This direction is from naught to 1. When you say from M naught towards M 1, from M naught towards M 1, not towards 1, from naught towards 1, R naught 1. Right expression for F naught 1. write F, not one, draw the diagram. One full page. F not one, yes. Magnitude, capital G. Mass, M not, M one. Distance, R not one or one not, makes no difference. Direction, R not one. This is one. Second, yes, same logic. Replace M 1 by 2. And for n particles, yes, G, M naught, M n, R n naught square, R naught n. This distance is what? R 2 naught, R n naught. This direction, yes. From naught towards n. So, if you sum up all these, then common g m naught is common. What you get is m1 by r1 naught square direction r naught 1 plus m2 by r2 naught square r naught 2. And up to mn by r n naught square r naught n. Total force this is how you represent it in theory, but its practical form is through conceptual example, which is very simple. If there are forces acting, resultant force is what? Which sum? Vector sum. It is not. It is not simple algebraic sum. It is vector sum because force is a vector quantity. 2 minutes with you to complete. 2 minutes. Refer to numerical part. Refer to book. Numericals based on question number 1 and 2. Newton's law of gravitation and super principle combined together. Numerical number 3. Question is, a rocket is fired from the earth towards the moon. At what distance from the moon is the gravitational force on the rocket is 0? Mass of earth is 6 into 10 to the power 24 kg. Mass of moon is 7.4 into 10 to the power 22. And orbital radius of moon is 3.8 into 10 to the power 8. Neglect the effect of sun and other planets. Draw a diagram. Earth. Center of Earth. Another object is Moon. Center of Moon. When you fire a particle, moves along this line, along the line joining the centers of the two. There is some point, point P, where Yes. Gravitational force on the rocket is zero. Why? At this point only. Force, this is Earth. Force on this mass due to Earth. Moon will attract it towards right. There is some point in between the two where the force due to Earth becomes the force due to Moon. The two forces will cancel and the result effect is zero. It is distance between the two is given. Orbital radius of Moon means what? Distance between say capital R is given. You have to find out distance from surface from Earth, center of Earth or center of Moon. Yes. You have to find out distance from the Moon. That means from center of Moon. Let this distance be x. What about this distance? R minus x. R, capital R, distance between Earth and Moon is given. How much? 3.8 into 10 to the power 8. R is given as 3.8 into 10 to the power 8 meters or kilometers? Meters. So, from concept point of view, step number 1 is Fe magnitude is equal to Fm magnitude. Draw the diagram, write values for Fe and Fm. Help. Mass of Earth, Me. Mass of Moon, Mm. Let this small mass be any mass, M0. Force between Earth and M0. Then force between Moon and M0. Fe, force on M0 due to Earth. Yes, formula capital G, mass of Earth into M0 divided by R minus X square. Capital G, mass due to Moon into M0 divided by x square. Capital G cancel, M naught cancel. Mass of Earth is given how much? Yes, 6 into 10 to the power 24. Mass of Earth is given 6 into 10 to the power 24. R 3.8 into 10 raised to the power 8, sorry. Minus x square is equal to mass of Moon, yes, 7.4 times power 22 divided by x square. Only unknown in this equation is x. So, solve and confirm value of x. 1 minute for calculation. Anyone with the answer, please? Yes, comes out to be what? X is equal to what? 3.8 in 10 to the power 7. 3.8 into 10 raised to the power 7 meters. Numerical number 4. Numerical is. Estimate the mass of the sun. Assuming the orbit of Earth around the sun to be a circle, distance between sun and Earth is 1.49 into 10 to the power 11. Capital G is equal to 6.66 into 10 to the power minus 11. First part, you have to draw a diagram. Sun, mass of sun, MS. Surrounding Earth, small m. Earth moves around sun. Yes, gravitational force provides necessary centripetal force. Let the distance between the two be r. 1 minute. Work out the concept to be used. You have to find out what? Yes, you have to find out mass of sun. Given is R. How much? 1. Into 10 raised to the power? Approximately 1.5 into 10 raised to the power 11. 15 crore kilometers. This is meters. Draw the diagram and work out the concept. Gravitational force formula, capital G mass of sun into small m by r square. 2. Centripetal force is equal to m v square by r. 1. 2. M r omega square. Why I want to write in terms of omega? Because its time period is known to me. Comparing the two, G, mass of sun, mass of earth by r square, third is nothing but equation number 1 and 2 is equal to m r omega square. M, m cancel. Mass of sun is equal to what? Mass of sun is equal to r cube omega square divided by capital G. Omega is equal to what? Omega is equal to what? 2 pi by T square divided by capital G. What you get is mass of sun is equal to R cube 4 pi square over G T square. R is given 1.5 in 10 to the power 11, 4 constant, pi square is constant, capital G is constant, T time period. How much time Earth takes to move around sun? 365 days, capital T, 365 days, but you need to change it to hours, 24 hours, then minutes, 60 minutes, then seconds, 60 seconds, equal to whatever the number of seconds. Write this one, calculation at home, not here. Answer you will find approximately 2 into 10 raised to power 30 kg. Approximate value